Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Dalzino YouTube channel. Today I am going to share with you guys a few tips on how to become a better flanker in Paladins. Before we jump into the tips, let us see the definition of flank. According to Google Dictionary, flank is the right or left side of a body of people such as an army, a naval force or a soccer team. For verb, be on each or on one side of, which is you have to guard or strengthen a military force or position from the side. And attack down or from the sides, or with gunfire from the sides. So the keywords are from the sides and from the back. Tip number 1. Never fight head on. If you look at a book of Sun Tzu, The Art of War, section 11, number 61, by persistently hanging on the enemy's flank, we shall succeed in the long run in killing the commander-in-chief. In war, killing the commander-in-chief of the enemy team is the primary objective. Adapting to this game, the objective depends on the game mode you are playing. Whether in siege, capturing the point and push the payload until the end of the path or prevent the enemy from pushing their payload to your base. Onslaught, capturing the point until the first team to 400 points win. Or team deathmatch, the first team to get 40 kills win. Adapting this rule, we need to disable the furthest and deadliest enemy champions such as Strix. Snipers like Kinesa and Strix can provide an enormous damage to our team from afar. Consider them as our priority. Looking at the Art of War, section 1, number 23. Attack him where he is unprepared. Appear when you are not expected. This rule is straight to the point. You just need to get at their back or sides and finish them ASAP. For example, in the video, I am sneaking from the right side of the enemy's team, encountering Bug. While fighting, I heard there were 3 enemies in the area. I ran because I knew I am going to die if I fight all 3 of them head on. Sneaking from their backside, disable Strix right away without him being prepared. Hey, before we move on to another tips, consider to give it a like and subscribe to my channel if you like to see more videos. Tip number 2. Identify hidden or alternate paths in the map. Art of War, section 6, number 5. Appear at points which the enemy must hasten to defend. March swiftly to places where you are not expected. This rule are more similar to the previous one, only at a point where enemy will instantly and constantly defend, which is the objective. To make it clearer, combine this rule with the Art of War, section 7, number 13. We are not fit to lead an army on the march unless we are familiar with the face of the country. Its mountain and forest, its pitfall and precipices, its marshes and swamps. This rule is expanded further in Art of War, section 11, number 52, which is, we shall be unable to turn natural advantages to account unless we make use of local guides. These rules are telling you to know and master the terrain of the map. Every map has their own uniqueness and playing point for you to sneak in, kill the enemy, and sneak out of the site quickly. For example, in Splitstone Quarry, there are a lot of cover you can use to hide your presence. I took longer route and delayed my arrival into the battlefield to make them wonder why Moji is taking so long, is he hiding? Then I'm sneaking from the right, attacking Rome at first, then Genos since he is softer than Rome. After kill him, quickly dash into cover, then attack Imani by surprise. Tip number 3. Know your maneuverability. Most of the flank champions have higher maneuverability compared to other classes. Except for Skye, she has 2 invisible skills, but she is the slowest flank compared to the rest. Champions like Lex, Neve, Moji, and Zin has good maneuverability. Lex and Moji has 1 skill for movement. Lex's combat slide very handy since it has 3 seconds cooldown, allow him to quickly surprise enemy and get out of combat zone effectively. Moji's camper has longer cooldown by default, harder to kill and run efficiently, but you can use the magic barrier as defense while retreating. Meanwhile, for Mii and Zin has 2 similar skill types, movement type and dash attack type. Movement type can help you chase down enemy or run away like Lex and Moji. Dash attack type is a skill where you can quickly dash and dealing damage to the enemy. Alternatively, you can use this skill to run. So, these 3 tips are my personal favorite when I'm using flank champions. Not to forget, teamwork and communication in this game are the keys to victory, no matter how good you are in flanking. What do you think of these tips? Do you have any more tips to share it with new players? Keep your thought in the comment section below. Alright, I hope you guys enjoy watching this video. Don't forget to give a thumbs up if you like it, subscribe to see more like it. I'll see you guys next time.